Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to our channel. My name is Seema Shanai and today we are going to talk about structure of atom.
The topic we are going to talk about now is the line spectrum of hydrogen. When electric discharges pass through gaseous hydrogen, the hydrogen molecules dissociate and energetically excited hydrogen atoms produce or emit EMR of discrete frequencies. The hydrogen spectrum consists of a series of lines. Balmer in 1885, on the basis of experimental observations, said that if spectral lines were expressed in terms of wave number, then the visible lines would be represented by the formula nu dash, which is wave number, is equal to 109677, 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square centimeter inverse, where n is greater than equal to 3 and n belongs to the set of integers greater than 0. So the series of lines were known as Balmer series, and these were the only visible lines in the hydrogen spectrum. Rydberg noticed that all series of lines in the spectral series could be written mathematically as nu dash is equal to 109677, 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square centimeter inverse, where n1 belongs to integers, n1 is greater than 0 and n2 is equal to n1 plus 1, n1 plus 2 and so on. 109677 centimeter inverse is also known as Rydberg's constant. The spectral lines can be represented in the form of this energy level diagram. All the transitions from n greater than equal to 2 taking place to n is equal to 1 constitute the Lyman series. The ones taking place to n is equal to 2 constitute Balmer. The ones taking place to n is equal to 3 are Pastern, and to n is equal to 4 Brackett and n is equal to 5 Fund. These are all known as the spectral series. Lyman is when n1 is equal to 1 and n2 is greater than equal to 2. This rises in the UV region. Balmer series is n1 is equal to 2 and n2 is greater than equal to 3, and this lies in the visible region. Pastern is when n1 is equal to 3, n2 is greater than equal to 4. Brackett is n1 is equal to 4, n2 greater than equal to 5. And Fund is when n1 is equal to 5 and n2 is greater than equal to 6. And all three lie in the IR region. N1 is the state of the electron that it comes to, and n2 or n3 is the excited state. The diagram depicts the energies of different stationary states of an hydrogen atom and is known as an energy level diagram. Hydrogen has the simplest line spectrum. There are more complex line spectra for heavier atoms. The common features for line spectrum are the line spectrum of each element is unique, and there's like regularity in the line spectrum of each element. The next topic is Bohr's model of the hydrogen atom. Niels Bohr was the first to explain quantitatively the general feature of hydrogen atom and its spectrum. The postulates of the Bohr's model were: the first one is electron revolves around the nucleus in fixed energy, in circular paths of fixed radius and energy. These paths are known as orbits. They are also called as stationary states or allowed energy state. Orbits are arranged around the nucleus in concentric circles. Energy of electron in an orbit doesn't change with time. An electron moves from lower energy state to a higher energy state when required amount of energy is absorbed by the electron. Energy is emitted by the electron when it moves from higher to lower energy state. This energy change is not in a continuous manner. The third postulate is the frequency of radiation absorbed or emitted when transition occurs between two stationary states is given by nu is equal to delta E by H, which is equal to E2 minus E1 by H. Here E2 is the higher energy states and E1 is the lower energy states, and delta E is equal to the difference between the energy states. This is also known as Bohr's frequency rule. The angular momentum of an electron in a given stationary state can be given by MeVr is equal to nh by 2 pi, where n is equal to 1, 2 or 3. Me is the mass of the electron, V is the velocity and R is the radius of the stationary state. The electron moves only in those orbits whose angular momentum is an integral multiple of h by 2 pi, and that is the reason why only fixed orbits are allowed. According to Bohr's theory, the stationary states of electron are numbered as n is equal to 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. These integral numbers are known as the principal quantum numbers. The radii of stationary states are expressed as R0 is equal to n square A0, where A0 is equal to 52.9 picometers, which is equal to 5.29 into 10 power minus 12 meters. Radius of the first stationary state is called the Bohr orbit, which is equal to 52.9 picometers. Electron in the hydrogen atom is found in the first orbit, where n is equal to 1. As the value of n increases, the value of the radius increases and electron is present farther away from the nucleus. The most important property is the energy of the stationary state. The expression is En is equal to minus RH by 1 by n square, where n is equal to 1, 2, 3. RH is equal to 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 joules, which is also known as the Rydberg constant. The energy of the lowest state, that is the ground state, n is equal to 1, is minus 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 joules. N is equal to 2, E2 is equal to minus 0.545 into 10 power minus 18 joules. Energy of the electron and hydrogen atom has a negative sign for all possible orbits. The negative sign implies that the energy of electron in the atom is lower than a free electron at rest. A free electron at rest, that is an electron that's infinitely far away from the nucleus, is assigned an energy value of 0. The energy of free electron at rest can be mathematically expressed as n is equal to infinity and En is equal to minus RH by 1 by n square. As the n value decreases, the electron gets closer and closer to the nucleus and En becomes larger in absolute value and more negative. The most negative energy value is given by n is equal to 1. This is also known as the ground state or the most stable orbit of the hydrogen atom. When electron is free from the nucleus, the energy is equal to 0. The principal quantum number here will be n is equal to infinity and this is called an ionized hydrogen atom. An electron attracted by nucleus and present in orbit n, the energy is emitted and energy is lowered. The presence of negative sign in the equation depicts its stability relative to the reference state of zero energy and n is equal to infinity. Bohr's theory is applied to ions containing one electron similar to that of hydrogen atom, like He+, Li2+, Be3+, which are also called hydrogen-like species. The energy of these stationary orbits associated with these ions is written as En is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 Z square by N square joules, and the radius of the orbit is given by Rn is equal to 52.9 into N square by Z picometers, where Z is equal to the atomic number. The value of energy becomes more and more negative and radius becomes smaller and the electron becomes tightly bound to the nucleus. It is possible to calculate the value of an electron moving in the orbit. The magnitude of velocity increases with increased positive charge on the nucleus and the magnitude of velocity decreases with increase in the principal quantum number. Let's talk about the line spectrum of hydrogen in more detail. The radiation is absorbed by the electron if it moves from the orbit of smaller quantum number to that of a higher quantum number, where electron moves from lower energy to a higher energy state. Radiation is emitted when electron moves from a higher energy state to a lower energy state. The energy gap is equal to delta E, which is equal to E2 minus E1, which is equal to minus RF by NF square, minus of minus RF by NI square, which is equal to RF by 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square. The frequency is equal to delta E by H, which is equal to RH by H into 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square, which is equal to 3.29 into 10 power 15 into 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square. In terms of wave number, nu dash is equal to nu by C, which is equal to RH by HC into 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square, which is equal to 3.29 into 10 power 15 by 3 into 10 power 8, which is into 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square. So nu dash is equal to 109677 into 10 power 7 into 1 by NI square minus 1 by NF square. In case of absorption spectrum, NF is greater than NI, and the term in parentheses is positive and energy is absorbed. So the absorption spectrum has positive energy and energy is absorbed. In case of emission spectrum, Ni is greater than Nf and the term in parentheses is negative and energy is released. So the emission spectrum has negative energy and energy is released. So delta E value given by 2.18 into 10 power minus 18 joule into 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square is similar to the equation nu dash is equal to 109677 into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square derived by Rydberg empirically using experimental data. Each spectral line in the absorption and emission spectrum associated with particular transition in the hydrogen atom. Large number of hydrogen atom gives many transition lines or spectral lines. The brightness or intensity depends on the number of photons of same wavelength or frequency absorbed or emitted. The Bohr model fails to account for the finer details of the hydrogen spectrum. One such is doublet, which is two closely spaced lines. These are observed by using sophisticated spectroscopic techniques. It is also unable to explain spectrum of atoms other than hydrogen. The other fact that it is unable to explain is the splitting of spectral lines in presence of magnetic field, which is known as the Zeeman effect, and the splitting of spectral lines in presence of electric field, known as the Stark effect. The Bohr model also couldn't explain the ability of atoms to form molecules by chemical bonds. In the previous topics, we have observed two different values of Rydberg constant. There are two different things which are given the same name. Now, instead of calling both of these the same, let's call Rh dash and Rh to avoid any confusion. Rh dash is equal to 2.1787 into 10 power minus 18 joules, which is also equal to 13.6 electron volts. This is also called as the Rydberg unit of energy. Rh is equal to 109678.771 centimeter inverse. So 1 by lambda is equal to Rh into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by Nf square, where Rh is equal to 109678.771 centimeter inverse and lambda is greater than 0. Let's name this equation as 1. Delta E is equal to Rh dash into 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square, where Rh dash is equal to 2.1787 into 10 power minus 18 joules. Let's call this equation 2. So delta E is equal to Hc by lambda. Replacing the value of delta E by this equation and replacing 1 by lambda by this, we get Rh dash into 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square is equal to Hc into Rh into 1 by Ni square minus 1 by Nf square. The common terms on both LHS and RHS get cancelled, giving us Rh dash by Hc is equal to Rh. Putting the values of the constants, Rh dash is equal to 2.1787 into 10 power minus 18 joules divided by the Planck's constant, which is 6.626 into 10 power minus 34 joules second, into the speed of light, which is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second square. Converting the meters into centimeters, we get approximately 109678.771 centimeter inverse. So the Rydberg constant Rh is equal to the Rydberg unit of energy divided by Hc, which is Planck's constant, into speed of light.
Thanks for watching. Please like, share, comment and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon to get notified every time I post.